of the embassy, the question is, who's entitled to build that temple?
These are supposed to be the patterns for the elect and the king and the queen in the king's chamber. And one of those people has to be led to finding that capstone, which is something that no human being can do, showing the versatility in all the sciences, and the speech, and the sound, and the mappings, and the Torah, and the Tanakh, and names, and families, and it's a plethora of things. Plethora. So that's Beit, that's why they always put the queen, the Isis with a lyre on her head and a red moon. Let's go check and see if we can find something with wings. Yeah, we want to see if we can find something with wings. A lyre on her head and a red moon. Because we want to be proficient. So now that's not Isis. That's something else. It changes every time they present it in a different country. It's something different. But if we go back to the megaliths, even omegaliths, into the billions of years, we'll find these two signatures there. Thank you.
drifting. This rock I got to roll. So I hit the road and made my getaway. Restless feeling really got a hold. I started searching for a better way. And I kept on looking for a sign in the middle of the night. But I couldn't see the light. No, I couldn't see the light.
So it's going to stagger the world, but it has to, because everybody's based on pictures, but they can't figure out. And no one's giving us the answers in a full lexiconic mode. You see, Aquila, and they showed us in the movie. So the question is not who's going to get our bodies, from Korea, and who's going to move the embassy. The question is, who's entitled to build that temple? In order to be the high priest of the world, you have to understand the process. You have to be able to put a reference mark in where that light is. That's why it's there. Excuse me, and that's why they're on megaliths with round circles, and they're in the Zoroastrian with a circle and feathers, you know, or wings, always. These are things that people are walking under because they haven't defined them for us. So my job is to make sure I connect the names to the words in the dictionary and the Torah and Tanakh into that person. My study's been on Omnilexica since 2012. So here's the Earth. We'll say that's the moon, and that's the sun. That's all we know. But if we line these all up in an equinox precession, what are we missing? That. And I have been able to get a photo of that too, with all shaky as a shaky man I am. And in just a couple hours, this courtyard is going to be filled with the royal signs of Belodial title, for the king, priest, prince, who were waiting to fly in the tabernacle in the stars. Well, so I've already documented all these signs at that point. And these are the things that are presaged from before time to have those connections, because God knows before time. So he's giving us a chance every day to do something. And every day that we don't, we're in dereliction of duty, because we're under witchcraft confusion, because no one can tell us what these are. No one ever points to the Cygnus cross. Cygnus, also in phonetics, S-I-G-N. We have Aquila, Lyra, Dodge, a new ruler, Chrysler, the Ram. The Ram goes to the one with the Nissan. The king, the Nissan, the Ben Yosef king, the Trump angel. Is that on our dollar bill? No, it's not. That's a bird that flies. So I would never be able to battle that with any human being, because they're not telling us that it's in the stars, are they? Nope. Well, anyway, that's where we got some problems. To be the high priest of the world, you have to understand the process. You have to be able to put a reference mark in where that light is. That's why it's there. And you'll have to be able to trace these for years and years. Excuse me. And that's why they're on megaliths with round circles, and they're in the Zoroastrian with a circle and feathers, you know, or wings.
So there's our moon, and now it's gone past. It's going over into the west, and the sun and the moon and the star Aquila
and Lyra, they pass through that line. See that west line? Somebody said, as the sun rises in the east and sets in the west, so shall the sign of the coming of the Son of Man. So every year that anybody's been telling me that's a sign since Ronald Reagan's been in there has been absolutely positively wrong. Reproduction. It's an Aleph, secondary champion, famous warrior. And it's a gatekeeper who is like God. Those are all archetypal things that stick to that guy. He's supposed to be coming now. So we don't have the correct understanding, because that's what the moon cycle is behind his head. See, you got it in the wings. And we got to stop looking at the cartoon character. You look at the principles, the archetypal. He's also known as an Alpha and Omega. See, Aquila, now it's a different name. But they go to the same thing. In Chaldean, this is going to go to the gatekeeper, famous warrior who is like God. How do I know that? And in just a couple hours, this courtyard is going to be filled with the royal signs of Belodial title for the king, priest, prince, who were waiting to fly in. The tabernacle and the stars. So I've already documented all these signs at that point. And these are the things that are presaged.